That boy ain't right.
Ella says she saw Hank hit his son.
Really? Well, I heard he threatened a clerk in Meglemart with a hammer.
Mm-hmm. Dum-dum. Da-da-da-da. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Ba-ba-ba-ba.
I borrowed your truck this morning, Uncle Hank. It wouldn't start at first because you had a clogged fuel line, but I blew it clean.
So what are we doing out here?
We're going to get snackered, I tell you what, boy, man. I want to get all messed up and it just blew our mind. It's a 360 dang old wind, man.
Yeah, let's go.
When I grow up, I'm going to drink this stuff every day, just like my dad, and fly jets and maybe even be an astronaut.
I'm going to live in London and be a rich millionaire and have people killed.
I'm going to sell propane and propane accessories, if my grades are good enough.
You had the coolest mom. She smells like Miracle Whip.
Okay, the 24-hour oath of silence starts now. Here are your silence sticks.
Those are Slim Jims.
That's what the white man calls them. Wamatanya calls them silent sticks to test your spirit of shutting up. Each time you talk, I take a bite. Talk 5 times and you're out. 24-hour silence, starting now.
Right now?
Bobby, son, you just talked. Now I'll let that pass, but don't talk again.
Thanks, Dad.
Son, give me that Slim Jim.
I'm hungry.
No problem.
Mr. Hill, wake up!
Ha! That was a test. Joseph, give Mr. Dotrieve a bite of your silence stick. Remember, kids, you never know when you're going to be tested. Now, who else is hungry?
I am.
Gotcha. Bobby, Randy, Garth, pass your silence sticks up. See, kids, it's harder than you think. You don't want to end up like Randy's dad.
My dad's a successful patent lawyer.
Not in the eyes of Wamatanya.
I'm still hungry. Who wants a dollar? Say me.
Me!
Well, these things are addictive.
Wamatanya, Mr. Gribble's not wearing his
Bobby, you just got 4 in a row. One more bite and you can't make straight arrow.
I'll take that jerky now.
What's that smell? You been playing this with your feet?
That's cheese, Dad.
Why would there ever be cheese on Betsy?
It's funny. It's a comedy routine. You know, you play the guitar with a piece of cheese, and you go, hey, look at me. I'm Eddie Cheddar. You know, it's from Celery Head.
What is a celery head?
He's the world's best comedian. He glues things.
Yes, I love my family.
Yeah, now you're getting it. That's the kind of love I have for Betsy. I'm going back to sleep. You coming?
I'm already up. Besides, I wouldn't want to make Betsy jealous. And I would like to see that guitar come home and chicken fry a steak after substitute teaching all day. Ow.
We meet on the golf course. He compliments my perfect swing. We start talking about music, cut an album, go on tour, open a chicken franchise. How's that gonna happen now?
Ma'am, you're gonna wanna angle that glass.
You're blowing it.
You're gonna get nothing but foam. Yep.
You know, Mr. Hopper, I just loved you in that movie. You know, the one where you played a mad villain.
Come on, Peggy, you wild thing. Let's drive straight down to Mexico, huh? Come on, right this minute.
Mexico. I wonder what a wife goes for down there, huh? One guitar? Two guitars? I will have to ask Hank.
Fish sticks?
Oh.
So what you thinking about there, Stu?
I'm thinking about flipping that steak there.
Alrighty.
No! Flip that other one!
Don't go away.
We'll be right back with more of Make a Steak.
At Megalobar, you're shopping for the rest of your life.
How you doing out there? I'm Chuck Mangione. You know, even celebrities have to hunt for bargains. That's why I go to the Megalomart, where shopping feels so good. This week, 12 5-pound bags of gourmet chocolates for $10.
Another thing I hate about Buckley, he always takes me to All You Can Eat and says that I have to sneak off his plate so I just get iced tea. And then he's too scared of getting caught to share.
Ooh, I hate guys like that.
And why do boys with braces always want a French kiss?
Pass me some more of that cookie dough. Mmm. I never knew you could eat it raw. It's almost as good as ice cream.
You know, they make ice cream with cookie dough already in it.
Damn, sister, get me my keys. Quarterback, huh?
Varsity.
Love your mama?
You know I do.
She cook with a gas range?
Propane.
Is Luann gonna marry her new boyfriend?
Well, you never can tell, but my guess is, yeah.
Luann!
That's Buckley. Those better be for me.
Nah, they're for me for later. Where's Luann?
Could you really be such a fool? Woe is you, Hank Hill. Woe is you.
What are you eating?
Nothing.
You are eating your emotions, aren't you?
Maybe, who knows? I don't know. I don't care. Whatever. This was a nice idea, Pig. Get us out of that house. Son, they got 8 kinds of ketchup here and 3 kinds of catsup.
I'm going to have some of that fried chicken and a fried plate of fried chicken, french fried side, and fried and some fried okra.
Luann! And Boomhauer, too. Well, isn't this a nice surprise?
Is that gravy lumpy tonight?
Hi, Aunt Peggy. Uncle Hank.
I'll take a bowl of the white gravy and a bowl of brown gravy.
So, Hank, man, I don't know what you're thinking, man, but y'all got to know, man, that ain't no dang old Woody Allen with that little soon leave, man. This ain't nothing going to happen.
Boomhauer didn't dump her, you did.
What? What was that?
She said Boomhauer didn't dump her, you did. Pass the ketchup.
I'm getting a bite. Is there any chicken fried steak left?
Here.
What's this?
It's Megamucil. I take 10 heaping teaspoons in a glass of water every night to stay regular.
I don't want to know that.
At least drink the water. If you drink enough water, it'll flush out your system
blah,
and keep
blah,
it clean.
Blah, blah,
I'm telling you that it's good for you.
Hey, eggs and sausage. That looks good. Peggy, where's my breakfast? What are these?
I baked muffins.
So, good for you. Where's my sausage?
Well, we're out of sausage. Hey, try a muffin. They are oat bran.
Sure.
You should eat those, Dad. They help you make.
Give me that.
Oh, Nancy, I'm worried about Hank. He hasn't done his business in 4 days.
Okay, but I've got one that's guaranteed to work for you, Hank. You take a spoonful of bacon grease.
I'm not eating bacon grease.
You didn't let me finish.
I'll have some skirt steak, some brisket, a little piece of that New York steak, a couple of them steak fingers, and a burger.
Oh, Hank, please, have just one veggie.
Oh, all right. Put some macaroni and cheese on there, too.
Ooh, chocolate sauce. Can I have some?
No, Bobby. This is an ordinary chocolate. It is a laxative for your father.
Oh.
Where'd you find this chocolate sauce, Peg? It sure is good. Here, Bobby, try some.
Okay, I thought you'd never ask.
Bobby, you know what that is.
So?
What is it?
Laxative.
I'm sorry, but apparently your low-fat, high-fiber diet is not working.
Well, maybe Hank just needs to give his low-fat, high-fiber diet a little more time. Isn't that right, Hank?
Yes, all right.
Not dogs. Now, what are these, hot dogs?
No, they're not dogs. They're made of tofu.
Tofu? I can't eat that crap.
Then try this fofu. It's a tofu substitute for the tofu intolerant.
Mm-hmm. Now, would that be good for a man who's constipated?
Peggy.
Well, I didn't say it was you.
Is this for your husband?
Yes. And we will also take a quart of your brown rice broth.
Do you have anything that tastes good?
No.
No, watch out behind you. No! Oh, God, Gatorade all down his back.
No, no, see, what I'm saying is salad don't always have to have salad in it. See, there's potato salad, and
I never thought Hank would have the willpower to give up everything he enjoyed in life.
Well, that's not Hank. That's me. I mean, if it was up to him, he'd still be eating burgers in the backyard with Dale, Bill, and Boomhauer. He'd still be drinking beer and shouting at the TV set and having a lot of fun and...
I feel like I've been trying to be someone else lately, eating food I don't eat, and I'm just not going to do it anymore. And if I don't ever poop again, well, that's just going to be who I am. I'd rather die with a burger in my colon than live and eat fo-foo.
I read somewhere that the Chinese language has 70 words for rice, but no word for friend.
But you promise.
Why go? I could just stay home. Order a bucket of chicken and watch Hee-Haw. Same thing.
Come on, Bobby, have some seconds. The girl's lapping you.
I've never had beef chop suey before.
Really? Oh, you poor dear. You know, I read somewhere that in certain parts of China, meat is as scarce as toilet paper.
Well, where you read that?
Oh, who can remember? You know, as a substitute teacher, I have to review all sorts of learning materials. Maybe it was on a placemat. I hope you all save some room for my famous apple brown Betty. The recipe is a closely guarded family secret, passed on from my mother's mother to my mother to me. And someday, I will give it to my Bobby.
Well, at least the brown Betty was good.
You must give me a recipe.
Oh, man, you know I can't do that. But what I can do is offer you some leftovers. Here, now just reheat this for 10 minutes. Oh, I have already said way too much.
Oh, come on, Peg. Remember when you first moved here from Montana? You called Pop Sody Pop?
Come on, stop dawdling, Luann. We've got to pick up that pizza before the cheese gets cold and the pineapple gets hot.
What's the rush? If we're not there in 30 minutes, it's free.
Me? I chew through the leash. I bet it tastes just like a Bible cover.
Oh, look, it's Piggy Hill, my new best friend.
No.
She's so pretty in her little yellow sundress.
Oh, man, you are so sweet. I could just mix you up in some jello and eat you for dessert.
Oh, Piggy Hill, look at husbands. Too bad men don't get along like we do. We get along. Men stupid. Women smart.
Mm-hmm. The whole world over.
Hey, Peggy Hill, look what I make. Peggy Hill Brown Betty.
Oh, but that's impossible. I never gave you the... Oh. Where'd you get my granny's recipe?
I figured it out myself. And then make it better. Her recipe missing one thing. Flavor.
I beg your pardon?
I add flavor. Nutmeg flavor. Now it tastes much better. Don't you think, Peggy Hill? Please to try Peggy Brown Betty. Would you like a Peggy Brown Betty? It's tasty, delicious.
Well, Peggy, to be honest, I have always had trouble keeping your Brown Betty down, but this here is pure heaven.
Those burgers look pretty done to me.
Not yet.
You might want to turn them now.
Too soon.
Okay. You might want to turn them now.
No. Please go away.
Please, Con, you're burning them. That's too much char.
Shut mouth, that open mouth.
Boy, howdy. That is the best damn burger I ever ate.
Stop, stop pushing. There's enough for everyone. If three of you go home right now, ha ha ha, joke.
I tell you.
Hello? Dog Pound? Yes, hello? I'm looking for dog. Sweet, sweet dog. Have big barbecue today and dog run out. Oh, about 20, 25 pounds.
Good Lord, it's true.
Oh, I call you back.
Why would they shoot people? Human meat's tough, flavorless. They should be out hunting for more dogs.
Oh, no, Ladybird!
That psycho redneck is back. Why he's so mad? You do something wrong?
You're the one who insulted his propane.
You're the one who made fun of Peggy Hill's monster feet.
Open up, Con. Open up, now.
Get my bat.
Go to your room.
What? You say, go to your room? Huh. I say, go to your room. You spank?
No, sir. Don't believe in it.
No, me neither. I think it barbaric.
How about bed without dessert?
Never fail.
Huh. Wouldn't figure a child could be motivated by a fortune cookie and an orange slice.
Oh, the cookie may be small, but it contains great wisdom. And orange is sweet and juicy.
You know, Con, we may deny our kids completely different desserts, but they both go to bed hungry. And that's what really matters.
This is my granny's five-alarm jambalaya.
Mmm. You want less hot, more spicy. Add nutmeg.
Less hot, more spicy, and nutmeg, of course. Okay. Aunt Laverne's chicken fried chicken.
Mmm. Too much Mrs. Dash. Add nutmeg.
Too much Mrs. Dash. And this here is my very own rabbit stew.
Ugh! Rabbit! You rednecks will eat anything.
I don't want Grandpa at my party. The kids are already gonna hate me because you got the wrong kind of bean dip.
What's wrong with the bean dip?
Aren't you glad I didn't say banana? Huh? Huh?
Oh, why are you so pissed off for Peggy Hill?
Oh, nothing. Just Hank's father. He's driving in for the party.
Oh, Lord, that crazy Cotton Hill.
I heard after Hank's mother left Cotton, he married his 16-year-old nurse. Dee Dee is 39, thank you very much.
Although parts of her are much younger.
Knife and fork dug their grave, man.
Who wants a burger?
Well, I'll take that steak.
The hell you say? Did you win World War II? This ribeye is for my daddy.
Everyone thinks your party's cool, Bobby.
I'm having fun.
Your wife divorced you.
Oh, crap it! Nail it! Ooh, bash it! Bash it!
It must be made of kryptonite or something.
Now, we're crying out loud.
Oh, good Lord, Cotton. You gave him a loaded shotgun?
Well, you don't give a toy without batteries. Come and get your Tootsie Rolls. So, Bobby, what you gonna do with your life?
I'm gonna be a prop comic. I'm working on this bit where I stick a green bean up my nose.
Well, now that sounds promising. Hank, Bobby and me have decided he's gonna stick vegetables up his nose. He's not going to take over the family gas station.
Dad, I don't work at a gas station. I sell propane and propane accessories.
Don't sass me, boy. You ain't too big for me to give you a licking.
Oh, Dad, you old skunk.
Come on, grease monkey. Let's tangle.
All right, Cotton. Now you are breaking my good dishes. It's time for you to leave.
Oh, come on.
Come on. I will fix you a to-go plate. Don't worry about the horse. If it comes back, we'll call the rental place.
What do you say I drive you to school today, Bobby?
Hope you're all hungry.
Good-looking breakfast, Peg.
Yeah, I see bacon. I see ham. I see steak. Sausage! Where's my sausage? There's no sausage!
Well, Cotton, you are welcome to march yourself down to the Safeway, but I have to get ready for work.
See, Bobby? Woman works. Man loses his sausage. You're all skin and bones, girlie. Put some corn pone on them hips.
I don't want any Grandpa Hill. Don't want to get fat.
That's not for you to worry about. You will never know if you are attractive. It's up to a man to tell you that. You keep eating, and I'll tell you when to stop.
Touch me again, and you'll be wearing that corn pone, old man.
Hooey! Feisty! Now, why don't you order us some food?
Really? Dad never lets me order.
Yeah, well, you went with your daddy today. Go to it.
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am?
Oh, good sweet. You'll never get no service that way. You gotta get her in the moneymaker. Hey, Missy, how How about some sandwiches?
You're right. It's my fault. Why, oh, why didn't I serve that poor man his sausage?
Supper time, Colonel.
You forgot my beer. Go on. Get me my beer, woman.
Mom, I'll take my dinner in here, too.
Bobby, you will not. We eat our dinner in the kitchen.
Boy wants his dinner in here.
Well, we eat in the kitchen.
Here?
Kitchen.
Here?
Kitchen.
Here!
Hank, for God's sake, I need a little support here.
Well, Peggy, it might be nice for a change to have dinner in front of, the TV.
Well, go on, woman. Get me my dinner. You've had enough cake, Connie.
What are you doing?
A man's gotta tell a woman when to stop eating. You're looking kinda chunky. Ooh, she's moody. Must be PBS. Let's go. I gotta see a man about a horse.
Now, what do you say we get an ice cream?
Now, men, the game of Boggle is really quite simple. The goal is to make words out of these 25 letter cubes.
Oh, yeah!
Ba-mi tom yum.
It's gotta be a real word, honey.
Yes, ba-mi tom yum, Thai spicy noodle soup. Tasty and delicious.
So take it from me, Chuck Mangione. Unplugging the iron feels so good. Can you dig it?
Bobby, wait! Use a coaster!
Uh-oh.
Fine day, isn't it, boy?
Oh, Hank, there is a tile in the bathroom that I think we missed.
Really? Well, I better check that out. Well, I found the tile. Thank you very much, Peggy. And I looked at it, but there's still some more tile for you to look at.
You know, I think I will save the rest of my tile for after breakfast.
Will you stop talking about your stupid tile? If it's so dirty, go clean it. And if it's clean, you can shut up!
Hey, I've got an idea. Let's go eat at that place we used to go when we smoked. With the jazz combo?
Smokies?
Yeah, that's the one. Yep, same old Smokies. Place hasn't changed a bit.
Now, where is old Smokey? We would love to say hi.
Oh, Smokey's no longer with us.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Well, it's for the best, darling. Those last few years when it spread to his bones. Smoking or not smoking?
I don't think I like this club. You all whine too much and the coffee's bad.
Here's to three of the bravest individuals in all of Ireland. To the hills and their tobacco-free future.
My God, are you still talking?
Why's my potato got skin on it? I hate skin!
I will not sit here and have my work insulted. Mm. What, do you think the potatoes just fly into the bowl and mash themselves?
I know y'all don't mean none of those harsh words. It's just a nicotine withdrawal.
Why is she still talking? I wasn't gonna smoke it, I swear.
I know. You did it. Good boy. Here's your treat. Bobby, Aunt Peg, come in here. Let's celebrate. I'll make an icebox cake. Bobby, why don't you... Hey, where's Aunt Peggy?
Bethany, it does not matter if your avocados are hard. Life is hard. You cannot make authentic guacamole out of lima beans and Ritz crackers. All these people. Gringos.
I'm just glad you're in charge of the block party this year, Aunt Peggy. Last year it was all Tex and no Mex.
Oh, he's the devil. Anyway, Hank, would you please tell Boomhauer Swiss cheese is not Mexican. It is American. I want him to bring some Monterey hack.
I lost another client. Thinks I use too much chemicals. I say Sara Lee uses more chemicals than I do. I have personally taste-tested each and every household insecticide.
Yo, Peggy wants me to barbecue 20 pounds of Mexican sausage.
I got half a tank of propane left. You think that's enough? I figure I could top it off with some lighter fluid or something.
Oh, Bill, you don't want to be mixing and matching your petrochemicals. The Propane Association recommends that you...
It'll be fine, Bill. Burn is burn.
Burn is burn. I gotta remember that.
Aunt Peggy, Buckley wants to bring his .38 to shoot off at the block party, but Uncle Hank said nothing bigger than a .22.
Well, now... He is the block captain, Luann. Now, I coat the churros with azucar, or sugar. Well, how very odd. Now, what the heck was that?
Feast, Buck Queen. Feast.
I just hope Hank doesn't blame Dale for what happened.
Oh, no, Nancy. He knows Dale was only doing his job. He gave him a 50-cent raise.
Oh, sugar. We're out of sugar, Shug. You know, I think there's some more in the basement.
Oh, no, I'll go get it. I'll get it. Ah! Oh, yeah! Come join the block party. Have at least one margarita before Bill finishes them all.
It's not margarita, okay? It's margarita.
I'm having a party next Sunday.
Can I come?
I guess. Arm the photon torpedoes.
Is there gonna be cake?
Nope. This party's gonna be different.
Different how? There's gonna be girls.
Fire!
A boy-girl party? Already?
Well, I don't think I wanna go.
Well, that's just fine, Bobby. Would you like a juice box?
Hey, Bobby, wanna eat?
What? Okay.
Hank, can I speak with you?
In a minute.
In the kitchen?
This better be about dinner.
Do you know anyone who would like a hot fudge sundae?
I'm sorry. We're all out of diet.
Wow, you look good.
You look better than good. You look like a weatherman.
I'm just gonna have some fruit and a glass of skim milk. I want to slim down for Joseph's party. Guess who? You look so tense. I have something special planned for tonight.
Bobby! Honey, I need some help with the groceries! Bobby!
Relax, baby. It's just you and me.
Bobby!
Mom!
Junior, come home for dinner. Your prawn's getting cold.